Hello everyone, welcome to Desi Liverpool Fan TV. Hi, I'm your host Abhishek. Transfer updates, finally on 1st of July, transfer window open, and we have quite a few updates, not in terms of incoming, but outgoing. We have three, really, one on loan and two on permanent. So first of incoming, Seb Vandenberg. I hope I pronounced his name correctly. We signed him from PEC Zolo from Eredivisie, and noise from English media is that Liverpool local media is that he's one for the future, really, and probably next Van Dijk or De Ligt, as we like to call, because Ajax were keen on him, trying to sign him. From it says signed to replace De Ligt, and even Bayern Munich were also said that they were keen, and when he was having medical with us, they tried to hijack the deal, but he Seb Vandenberg or junior VVD has hard set on us, so he joined us, and fee was around 1.3 million and it could raise to 4.4 million in if he makes 350 appearances. And I heard his first interview, he came across a very good guy, and he talked about short-term goal would become, quickly came into first team and then become a legend in a long term. So I don't know really about him. I read a lot of things. I heard a lot of podcasts from Eredivisie expert or even from Liverpool side. I tried to get more info on him, and I figured it out that he already played 20 games in Eredivisie, and he has been, he is a technically very good defender and good on ball. But one thing is what I could read that aerial ability is not that good, but he's quick. Yeah, he's very confident on the ball. So that's how we like to play. Initially, he will be in our academy with whoever, another Dutch young defender. But there are some talk like, there is interest in Lovren from AC Milan, but they want to some bargain fee, and Liverpool won't budge on 25 to 30 million they are hoping to get from Lovren. So once Lovren leaves, probably he would be stepped into as a fourth center back. My initial thought would be that I do not want Lovren to leave. Anyone is hearing my channel for last year and a half, they would know that I hate Lovren. I dislike Lovren. But now when he's fourth choice center back, I'm okay with it. I do not want him to be first choice pairing with Van Dijk or even second choice. Matip and Gomez is my preferred choice for Van Dijk, any one of them. But for fourth choice, I'm okay with Lovren because he is a good defender. After all, I do not rated him. Just like Minoli, I did not rate him as a number one, but for number two, I'm quite comfortable. So same for Lovren. I could live with him when he is a fourth choice. So I do not want him to go. But if 30 million, we could deal with that. Yeah, but not less than 25 million, to be honest. We signed him for around 19-20 million. He was our costliest defender, so we would like to get some feedback because Michael Edward won't let get anyone cheap. So I think we will get that fee, and Milan, who are struggling with fair play, I think that will be too much, but I don't know right now. And if he leaves for 25-30 million, bye bye Lovren, thanks for the service. Other than that, stay here as a fourth choice center back, and I'll be comfortable. So, as I said, I do not intend to talk on rumors, but if that's what the point, that if Lovren leaves, Seb Vandenberg, or Seb, I will call him Seb because every time, single time, I cannot call the full name. So, Seb will be fourth choice center back. And as I said, I was hearing his interview and he was quite confident, really. So, I hope that it turns out like that, because I was listening to one of the Netherlands expert, and he was saying that he was not getting game time at PSG Zolo. No disrespect to them, but 13 in Eredivisie and coming to Liverpool, and he was frustrated that he was not given chance enough there. So I don't know if he signed for us and he's hoping to play a game. He better be very good, because we, as I said, we have three top defender, Matip, Gomez, and VVD is best defender in the world right now. So, and Gomez and Matip, if you in the first half of the season, Gomez was one of the best in the Premier League, and the second half, Matip was one of the best in Europe after Van Dijk. So we have a very good three center back. Lovren is also decent now. So if Sepp wants to dislodge any of them, he has to play blinder, probably at the De Ligt level, kind of. One more thing, I was going through David Murdoch from, he's from Mirror, and I was going through, he covered this story of Sepp, and he said that Liverpool will be only signing 20 million striker. He said that Liverpool is not looking to spend big. So that caused some stir in the fan that we have money to spend. Like, we sell Rafa Camacho to Sporting Lisbon for 5 million and add-ons of 2 million. We sell Danny Ings to 18 million and add-ons of 2 million. And then Gruich loaned out to Hertha Berlin again for 2 million loan fee. And so we have outgoing of 27 million, and we have only signed for 1.3. So if you think of this window alone, we have minus of net spend around, how much, 22 million, 25 million or 26 million. So if you think like that, and on top of that, Champions League money of 100 million. So we have money to spend, and I think the club is trying to play down. They do not want to be in the market, knowing that they desperately need something. And because there was a sound of Nicolas Pepe, there was buzz around him, and then it was shut down from all reliable sources for Liverpool, like Neil Jones, David Murdoch, Melissa Reddy, Liverpool Echo. Everyone shut down that rumor, saying that Liverpool are not want to sign. And fans started doing parallels of how we opt out of Naby Keita deal, and then later we signed him, even though it was after a year, but we signed him. And then we got in the, if it's this time only around June, I think later June or first week of July, we said that we are not going to sign Alisson. And later later we signed him up for record fee. But in June, I think the fee Roma was asking about 90 to 95 million, and hoping that Real will also pitch in for him, and there will be bidding war, which did not happen. And that made them go down to 65 million, and which helped us. So I think Liverpool is trying to avoid a bidding war of Nicolas Pepe or someone they want. It's July 1st, and we don't know really that what's the target are. Usually we will know. Last couple of season we knew that Alisson was target, even though we were denying. Same could not be said about Nicolas Pepe or any linked target like Bruno Fernandes. We don't know really that whether Liverpool wants or not. But right now the confirmed news is that, as I said, Gruich, Camacho and Ings left. Gruich on loan, and it has been said that Klopp is big admirer. He was Klopp's first signing. So Klopp said that in next season, he has part to play. And you could think that because I think Hendo will be around 30, Milly will be out of contract, 34, and then Lallana will be also 32. So he will have chance in midfield. This season we are packed. We have 7 good midfielders. Ox also coming back, hoping for Lallana also injury free. So it's good that Gruich left too, and he was very good for Hertha, and they were keen on him, and he also wanted to play one more season. And he said, I think in Feb, he said that he sees himself at Liverpool long term. So good, and if he have another good season there, and next year, why to spend 30-40 million on someone if we have our own player? So just a second. That's the Camacho one. He was making buzz in our academy, and Klopp said that Curtis Jones and Rafa Camacho are two exceptional players, and he also made debut for us against Wolves. And against Crystal Palace, I think he made block on Zaha, and Klopp after that match said that this is the most important block you will ever do in your life, kind of thing he said for Camacho, and he really rated him. And Liverpool did not wanted to sell me, but he just wanted to go back to his hometown, and Sporting was his dream. And we have buyback option and 20% sell-on clause, so we have covered if he comes like becomes like Bruno Fernandes, which is the what if you believe in football reports, everyone is saying that he has the ceiling of Bruno Fernandes, or someone is comparing him to young Ronaldo. So if he reaches that heights, probably we will buy him back. Or if Benfica moves him on, we will get 20% fee. So that's done. What else? Ings was it was like last year it was obligation to buy for 18 million and 2 million add-on, so we knew that signing is Ings will leave us, so good luck to him. Other than that, on transfer front, nothing from really Liverpool. As I said, that if they are keeping their cards very close to their chest, and we could not guess whom they want. One thing I just wanted to add, and not Liverpool related, I just read somewhere that Marcus Rashford has signed a 4-year contract. I don't know exact about wages, but it is reportedly said that £250,000 per week or £200,000 per week, but with add-ons it will go to £300,000 a week. So look, it's their money. Do whatever they want, but I feel like that he does not deserve that, and it will get inflated. And our like, if we believe that he is getting £250,000 per week, and Mane is getting only 130, 150. With add-ons, they will be around 180. So our players will be learned, not this season, but if you just think that in a couple of seasons they would be, I think, a boss. I am way better than them, and I'm getting only 2/3 of their salary. Just like if you see the Tottenham players, Christian Eriksen on 80, and lot of Tottenham players are like, even Alderweireld was on 60 or something. 60, 70. So they wanted a new, they say that they wanted new challenge only because of Tottenham wage structure. And I think, look, this season I know we are covered, but for next season or a season after that, if we need to somehow, I think, break our wage structure, and we have to re-sign our players, because if we keep on winning, and we have to sell out money to be on the top, because as City is also playing an average of 200K pound per week, and Man United probably 250. If we want to be in that bracket, I want to keep challenging. It sounds funny because Man United are not challenging, but you know that they have enough money to get it right, even though they are struggling, but they will get it right. And my lifetime, I have always seen that their problem does not last for long. This is the longest they have been struggling, but I know for sure they will get it right somehow, because they can throw money at, just like they are throwing at Marcus Rashford, they can throw more money. So eventually they will get it right, because they have lo loads and loads of money. We have to, I think we have to modify our wage structure, because sooner or later they will realize that they need a big pay, because they are superstars. Probably we do not talk as much as we should about our players, because I saw the star when Manchester United signed Wan Bissaka, and everyone started talking about him that he's the best right back and this and that. Look, he's a very, very good player, and I could recognize it, against us when they play. I could recognize only two, Wilfried Zaha and Wan Bissaka. They were that good. They were head and shoulder above the rest of their nine player. So he was good, and I have seen quite a few matches of Crystal Palace, and he is resolute in defending, and as he started in as a winger, so he will be good in attacking too. I haven't seen, and in Roy Hodgson team there is a not big scope of fullback attacking, we know very well. So next season it will challenge to him, and I do not want to talk much about them, but I was saying the point that we do not talk much about our players. Like Salah, Mane and Firmino, we know that they are world class, but we do not talk of them enough. But they will get recognition eventually around the world, and they would like the fee that pay and wage like Manchester United or City are paying, or even Chelsea. I think Chelsea or also have higher wage structure, so we will have to, because Klopp had a good team for a couple of years, but then it was picked off because of Bayern Munich wages really that they could afford and Dortmund couldn't afford. So we need to, I am sure that Liverpool will be looking at that, but I got worried really today. It was lingering in my mind that somehow, just like any other profession, if you know that company is paying higher, higher and higher, and probably they are half as good as you, you will think that I better be there. Not Man United, but some club, there would be clubs who can pay higher wages like Real, Barca and all those stuff. So that will tempt our player, not right now, but in a couple of years. We need to work on that, because we, Liverpool, have done lot of efforts to be on the top, reach the top, and just do not want to throw it away. And hopefully, I think our boards understands that, and Michael Edwards would be keen on that to re-sign again our players. Finger crossed. I don't know how many signing, as I said already, that I don't know, but I know that we will sign a versatile attacker for sure. We will get one. And talking of attacker, I just got reminded that there are quite a few website now saying that Origi is ready to sign 5-year contract. I'm all in for that. I just want Origi to be here. He has given me more happiness than any other player really right now. The goal against Everton, goal against Barcelona, goal against Tottenham in final, I'm so happy. And Newcastle too in the Premier League, he scored, and I was like mad at that time. So I really want Origi to stay, and if anyone knows that how to fund the statue, please let me know. I will join the party. I just want Origi statue to build outside Anfield. Really, thanks guys, thanks for watching. If any other signing or any other outgoing or anything else comes up, I'll definitely try to go live again. Thanks guys, thanks for watching. Bye bye.